Hello, everyone. This is Direwolf 20, and welcome to episode 58 of Direwolf 20's Let's Play series. I'm today gonna play a little bit with Super Circuit Maker because I've decided that I want to do a thing. I think these guys go together. Sweet. I would like to do a thing. I would like to automate today the flower petal production from Batania. I'm gonna do it kind of in a way that I've never really done before, which is cool. I think it should be fun, I think. And I'm trying to decide what else I might need. Probably want three eyes. Yoink. Ender Pulsar. I probably don't need more than what I've got, but I've got a few extras just in case. Glowstone, Exciter, miniature lamp. Might be cool to have some miniature lamps just to be able to see what's up, right? Miniature lamps are nice. So we played with Super Circuit Maker a little bit earlier on in the series. And the reason I want to play with him again today is pretty straightforward. And I'm going to show you why. So I would like to do the following. Here's the plan, and here's where we're going to accomplish the plan. I've added upgrades to these basic drawers. The first upgrade I added was the storage downgrade to limit it to one stack each, so we can hold one total stack of each type of flower in each of these storage drawers, which is cool. The other one I added was the redstone min upgrade, which we saw when we were doing the slates, but we only had that on one drawer. Now we've got it on four drawers. The redstone min upgrade. And basically what that does is it emits a redstone signal based on how full the smallest or the least full drawer is. So in this case, right, we've got a drawer with 21 red, 22 green, 15 black, and 11 brown. This is going to emit a redstone signal based on the fact that we've got 11 brown in there. And that'll be somewhere around a redstone power of 3. Cool. Now, this guy over here, we've got 14, 4, 6, and 2. This will emit based on the 2, which is a redstone signal strength of 1, right? So each of these different drawers, this is 14, 6, 13, and 8. So we're going to emit a signal based on 6, and that's going to be 2. Cool. Nice. So basically, we need to read these signals. And what we're going to want to do is figure out how full these drawers are. Right? And once they're completely full, we want to detect that. We're going to want to have something over here that's going to be generating these flower petals. And what I'd like to do is get all of these drawers completely full at all times. And to do that, I'm going to implement the following setup. I'm going to put void upgrades inside the basic drawers. That will make it so that any excess flowers get voided, right? Any excess petals. We're going to be producing a lot, and we're not going to worry about overproducing. So it's all right if we void it. They're pretty cheap to make. What we're going to do is, like, so say like this drawer starts filling up, right? If the red one gets full, it's going to void any excess reds, and it'll void any excess browns and everything. And I'd like it to fill all 16 types of flowers. And then once all 16 drawers are full, one stack each, stop the machine that's automatically producing flowers. Then, if any particular flower gets to the point where we've used some, right? Like, so say we, make a flower and we use some petals, right? It'll automatically turn on that machine, start producing all the petal types, and keep going until the petals are all full again. That's kind of the plan that I'd like to do. So it should be fun. It should be interesting. So what we need to do is the following. We need to measure this output. Boom. And we want to check for it to be full, right? So we wanted a full strength of 15, basically. From there, we're probably going to want to determine a couple things. Like, once it's 15, so I'm going to have to do probably some adding and subtracting, which is going to be a headache for me. Such a nuisance. The headache and the adder and subtractor, multiplier and divider thing is a nuisance. It's just a nuisance because Super Circuit Maker, instead of having the standard 15 or so, 0 to 15, so 16 different states of redstone, Super Circuit Maker has 256. So there's math. You have to do math. That's going to be a headache. So I could either do that, or I could throw a potentiometer on there and do the adjustment before it hits the Super Circuit Maker. So we could make the potentiometer from Draconic Evolution. We could make four of those and do a comparator. Four of those, and measure things before it gets there. That's probably another way to go about it. It saves us having to do the math on the Super Circuit Maker circuit, which is cool. Okay, so let's get to work, shall we? What I'm going to do is use insulated redstone conduits back here. Now, here's the deal. When these guys emit, it's always going to basically lose one signal strength, and I'll demonstrate that here in a moment. Okay, so this is a signal strength of one. If we put a conduit here and put this here, it's a signal strength of zero. Okay, this guy is a signal strength of three. If I put a conduit here and this guy here, it's going to be a signal strength of two is what's going to come out, regardless of how far this thing goes. See, so still a signal strength of two, right? So what I think I'm going to have to do is the following. So first off, we're going to have these guys coming off the back of here, and I want each of these to be its own color. So we'll make, like, this one can be red, this one can be green, this one can be blue, brown, and this one can be blue. Cool. Following that, we're probably going to want to run back here. Let's prepare for how big and what area we want to be building in. So, like, once I've got this area built out the way I want it, then I can decide where I want to put this redstone cabling stuff. So what I'm going to be making... Welcome to Britannia. Thank you. Cool. There we are. I need functional flora, one called the Jaded Amaranthus. Everyone likes flowers, right? Yeah. So feeding this thing mana from a nearby mana pool will have it quickly grow mystical flowers around it automatically. So it's going to automatically produce the flowers. And we're going to do other things shortly to break the flowers and pick them up and then transfer them into petals. It doesn't show me the range, though. Yeah. It doesn't tell me in here, so I need to look at the range. So we're going to need a Rune of Spring and some Redstone Root and a couple other flower types. So do we have a Rune of Spring handy? We have a Rune of Autumn. Spring is water and fire. We have water. We don't have a Rune of Fire handy, unless there's one sitting in the refined storage system by chance. Nope. All right, Rune of Fire is nether brick, gunpowder, and I know this. Nether wart. That's right. Do-do-do-do. Where did another work go? There it is. Cool. Putting away some junk because inventory issues. And then we want iron and gunpowder here. Cool. Now check this out. I'm going to hit that. We must have had some living wood in, or some living stone in the system, so we're cool. We don't need to make more. So you're going to make your rune. And while that's cooking, let's check out spring, which requires three saplings and wheat. Okay. So you can go in there. Anything else I don't need on me right now? Probably not this interface at the moment. Water, fire, three saplings, and wheat. Get ourselves another one of these dudes. Nice. I'm loving how, like, that's staying perfectly full stack all the time. That is super cool, and I really like it. Meanwhile, I need a piece of grass. If I don't have that, shears will go a long way towards getting it for me. You and you are cool. And what's cool is, in the past, your water and fire runes would get used up, but not so much anymore, which is neat. All right, so Jaded Amaranthus is purple, lime, and green. Purple, green, and lime. Neat. Perfect. Oh, I added seeds to the export bus, so that'll keep that full of a stack of seeds at all times. Neat. Now let's get our Mana Seer monocle. Which I don't keep on at all times because I found that the Mana Seer monocle also lets you see mana bursts through walls. That is an intended effect. Like, it's written in the book that it does it on purpose, right? So with it off, you no longer see it. When it's on, you do see it. And I don't like seeing those particles through walls. So that's why I don't leave it on all the time. Jaded Amaranthus has a range of... what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4 So, hey, guess what? That's a 9x9. Because it's the best size of anything. So we need a 9x9, right? So let's do... right, would that be a 9x9? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Seems 9x9-ish to me. And it doesn't have to be a 9x9. That's the range it can be. So, I mean, if we made this not quite as big, it would be fine. Wouldn't be that big a deal. Cool. I should have got my drill augment so that I could have 3x3 tunneling. Right, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I could dig that back 4 more, and we'd be cool, right? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, one more back. Sweet. Let's just get some lighting in here, because the 9x9, we know torches are going to work pretty well. For now, that will be good. Nice. And then take that drill augment out. Let's throw some stuff back into the refined storage system for us. I didn't mean to put away my teleporter, but that's what happens. And you no longer have the upgrade, right? Cool. So this can be dirt. We'll replace this all with dirt in a minute. But now that we have an idea of what this room is going to look like, so this is basically going to be creating flowers inside this room. And I'll probably have some kind of, like, ethereal glass or something that I can walk through in front. Just to make it look neat, right? And this will be all dirt in a minute. So that'll be good. So now that we know what that looks like, the cool thing about the Jaded Amaranthus, by the way, is it responds to a redstone signal. I believe it's accurate to state that any flower in Britannia that has a redstone root in the recipe will respond to a redstone signal. I believe that is an accurate statement. And as such, that's pretty neat. So we can basically go under here and feed this thing a redstone signal to turn the flowering thing on and off. And what we're eventually going to have is a timer that's going to pulse. That will do other things, but let's just dig all the way across here. Cool. And then we can put you and you away. Neat. I like it. Cool. All right, so that'll be the flower getting its redstone signal stopped, which will basically be this, right? And we're going to force up to be an out strong signal, right? So it's going to emit a strong redstone signal there, and then we're going to be good. Nice. All right, quick nap, and we'll be right back. So now what we're going to want to do is basically run some cabling straight down, right? So this is going to be all the different drawers. And I'm going to want to feed them into something down here that's going to be some kind of circuit. What that circuit's going to look like, I haven't exactly fathomed just yet, but I'm sure it'll look like something cool. Alright, so let's do this. Good deal. Okay. So you're going to come down here, and we're basically going to want to read the signal strengths of those things, right? So we'll probably have 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm trying to think of how this should look. I want it to be compact. And maybe I'll do it instead of with the potentiometers. Maybe I will do it with the super circuit maker stuff. Just because, like, why not? So I could do it like this, right? And that'll get us... I'm going to need a little bit more headroom here. Yeah, maybe instead I will actually go through with... getting the adders and subtractors from Super Circuit Maker, because it's going to be a much larger footprint if I have to have potentiometers and redstone comparators when I could do this on the circuit. So let's do it on the circuit. I might want tiny bundled wire too while I'm here. Just saying. Might be nice to have. I might need more of that. That'll be good for now. And then Super Circuit Maker, we're going to want adders, which are tiny plates in that. And they can be turned into all the other types. So let's make sure we have a couple tiny plates in there. That might be enough. 9? Sure, we'll find out. So I think there's a way to read what the current number is. And maybe that's what this guy is for, the multimeter. Just need a couple more tiny plates and I can get one of these dudes. Because one of my things I'm going to want to know is exactly what color, or what signal strengths are, so I can show you the math. So brown is probably the one that's emitting the strongest signal strength right now, right? So I'm going to, that'll be red, green, brown, and blue, right? So what we want to do is come into here and say, off the brown signal, you're going to be accepting energy in, right? And if I multimeter this, are you going to tell me what the signal strength is on it? Power level 34. Cool. When in reality, what brown is... is 2. So 34... what is it? 34? Seems weird. So if that came in, right, I would want to do a divide. Boop. Boop. Your power level is 0, right? So if I did a divide by 16, I'm going to want a constant. I might need, oh, didn't want to do that. I might need this constant to be here with a redstone boop in between. Right? So that is going to be 16, so you're a 0. Why are you a 0? You might need to be rotated. That's what we want, right? So that's the signal strength of 2. Neat. So I think that's cool. All right, back in a sec. So I think the next thing we want to do is have a subtraction sign. And that's going to be, we're going to subtract our constant here. Which will be, probably in the end, we're going to want this to be like 13 or 14. But for now, let's just make it 1 just to test this, right? So if we read this, right? So it comes in as 34. And we divide by 16 to get 2, right? I think that's right. And then that's like the actual signal strength, 2, right? And then we subtract, well, it's probably going to be like 14-ish, right? But right now we're subtracting 1 and we're getting 1. And then we're going to want to AND gate this with the next color, right? So that's cool. So now I've gone ahead and removed everything, right? And the reason I've done that is I want to have everything kind of doing things correctly. So what I'm going to do is connect all these guys to some bundled cabling, which should make my life a little bit easier. In theory. Okay, and we're gonna wanna equip the palette and brush here. And I think if I hold left alt, I can specify colors, right? Which is cool. So like this one is suddenly red, and this one can be green, and this one can be brown. And that one can be blue, is the color over here, right? Neat. So this works like bundled cabling. How cool is that? And if I wanted to, we're always going to be dividing and subtracting by the same numbers, right? So I could have those as constants on the board only once, and that would be neat. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. We're going to make constants on the board, okay, and they will be, let's say, white and orange, because I haven't used those colors yet, right? So white and orange will be your constants. White can be the 16 that we're dividing by, and orange can be the 1 that we're subtracting by, right? Cool. And then what we're going to want to do here is basically have a couple AND gates. So let's just say we're going to want like red coming out here, and then we're going to want to divide and then subtract, right? Let's get a few more pieces of the tiny pile. So we'll want to divide and then subtract. And what are we going to divide by? We're going to divide by white. Cool. And, well, you know what I should do is, what I should do is this. You ready? We're going to divide by white. And then we're gonna subtract by orange. And honestly, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what color you use for this part of it. So this is red going in there, right? So red is currently a power level of 7. Once we, what we wanna do is that and then that. So here, red's a power level of 7. Now it's a 1, and then when we subtract 1, it's a 0. See how that works? Nice. That's cool. All right. I'm liking this so far. So then the next set, and I just went and made myself more of these things, right? We'll have another divide and subtract here. Okay. And this will be the green one, let's say. Right? So you're gonna be that, you're gonna be that. right? So green's going to come in as a 0. Okay, that's cool. So then that'll be 0, and that'll be 0, and that'll be 0. That's cool. And is that is an accurate representation of what green is? Yes, I think that's correct. And then we'll do the same thing up here, right? So we'll probably have, like, it doesn't matter which ones we do in which order and where they go, honestly. But we'll do, like, blue here, and we could do the bundles like that. And then we'll do, white, orange, divides, and subtracts. Okay. And then this will be brown. Cool. This one I'm going to stick with just to keep the colors the same. And this can be blue. And then we want to do the read and the read and the read and the read. So blue might be coming in as 0 as well. Let's take this off for a sec so we can see that. Correct. Brown should be the one coming in at 34. So that's the higher number, right? So that's 34 divided by 16. Oh, that turned white. That's why. Aha. We're dividing by 1. Okay. So that's cool. So now we're looking at 34 divided by 16 is 2, minus 1 is 1. Neat. So now what we want to do is figure out if the drawers are actually full, right? So if this signal is on, in theory, it's going to mean the drawer is full. Okay. That's pretty much what we're going to be looking at. So let's put some torches there to detect fullness, quote unquote. Now this one, because we're only subtracting 1, like this is why this is still here, right? So this is kind of going to be a test, right? So in theory, if the drawer is full, it's going to turn off its respective torch, right? That's what we're looking to accomplish. So we want to do some kind of anding there to say like, hey, here's what's coming out of this, right? So if this is full, this torch turns off. Right. And I probably want to read from you. Right. So that's kind of like an andish gate. And we could probably even make this a little bit more compact. Right. So if this is full and this is full, turn on the torch, meaning this torch is going to be on when these two drawers are full all the way. Right. Is that logic correct? I think it is. And we want to do the same thing over here. Right. So read from these two. Have a torch here, right? So that when these two torches are on, that means we're ready to roll, right? And then you guys are going to be much the same. So you're going to read from here, and you're going to have feed into a torch, right? I think we could do that. Yeah. So that's kind of like an andish gate there. I might wind up putting the torch here just to have it on the same doohickey, right? So that should be good. So when these two are full, which we're going to simulate here in a sec, right? What I'll probably have, let's make like a full signal strength, right? So let's get some levers. That's how we're going to test this, right? Okay, and we'll have red, green, brown, come on you, don't be a nuisance now, and blue, okay? So if this one's full, it turns off that. If this one's full, it turns off that, which turns on that light. If this one's full, it turns off that one. And if that one's full, it's turned off that one, which turns off this. So once these are all full, it turns off this torch. If anyone is low or empty, that's a bad one to demonstrate with. If anyone is full or empty, that torch Yeah, I might need to change this up. Hang on a sec. There we go. I didn't need those middle torches. I just replaced them with wiring, right? So basically what this means is if any one of these are not full, meaning their levers off, this torch in the front turns off. Once they're all full, the torch in the front turns on. And that's going to do two things. One, it's going to stop a pulsar, which is going to be generating a redstone pulse, and that's going to be the ender pulsar here. All right, and we will do this. We could probably just put it like... doesn't matter where this goes to, but I want to make sure that it's set to emit a redstone signal, right? That's going to be like this dude, which we'll call color. Again, it doesn't matter which color we use because it's a separate signal strength, so we'll go with red. That's fine. And then you'll also be responsible for hitting up an ender pulsar, which is going to be set to read from the pulsar and output here. And your job will be to be channel green. Cool. Nice. That's pretty cool. Right? So if we ran some cabling here, and if we had, after we take a quick nap, if we had a couple lamps that we could test with this, a couple redstone lamps, as it were. As you can tell, this is not my forte. I'm decent at it, but not great. So I don't know if you guys noticed, but I was like, throughout this entire episode, like my brain was trying to figure out exactly how to get to work what I wanted to work. And there's probably a better way to do it. And Soren would probably laugh at me and be like, oh, Dire, this is terrible. And he'd be like, doot, 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 now it's three wires. That's Soren, but that's not me. I'm not that good at this stuff, if I'm being honest. But I'm getting there, right? So we could have these guys here, right? And this green, so the red one should be on. Oh, right, we have to do, where's my screwdriver? You need to be reading off that. Nice, cool. So when we have a full set of drawers, right? We're emitting a redstone signal on red, which is going to turn off the jaded amaranthus. And we're no longer pulsing green, which the pulsing green is going to be the thing that breaks the flowers and picks them up, okay? When any drawer is empty or not fully full, like that, we're pulsing. How cool is that, right? So let's actually change our numbers here real quick. So I think my subtraction number, instead of 1, should be 14, right? Maybe not, maybe it should be 13. Yeah, 13 is probably good, right? Because a steady redstone signal coming in seems to be, I can take this pellet off so you guys can read, 238, right? 238 is what we're getting from a full redstone signal strength, which I think is 256 minus 18. So maybe we're supposed to be dividing by 18. Yeah, maybe our divisor should be 18. I think our divisor should be 17, I think. So let's make that 17, right? So now what's coming in is probably a 14 signal strength, so that's 238. And then divided by 17 is 14, because that's the actual signal strength. And then minus 13 is 1. Cool. So then this can probably go 14. Neat. Okay, cool. So that's good. Okay, so that's pretty much where we want it, right? When they're emitting a full signal strength. Cool. So yeah, it's divided by 17 and then minus 13 because we're losing one signal strength from the wiring. So this is really coming in as a 14, even though the lever itself is emitting a 15. There's like one signal strength loss. All right, so that's cool. So that's going to be a wrap-up point for the episode. We'll come back next time and we will implement the jaded amaranthus and the pulsing system. By the way, this pulsar could probably be on a less frequent tick, like maybe once every 3 seconds. So like tick, 3 seconds later, tick, cool. And then that's on. So that circuit is good. That works. And we're going to use it next episode. For now, Darryl 20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. We'll come back next time and automate pedal production and some other things. Super Circuit Maker is fun. I think it's fun, at least. I hope you guys enjoy watching it, because I think it's super fun to build with. And that circuit just looks cool. Like, I'm proud of making that. Like I said last time I showed you guys Super Circuit Maker, don't be intimidated by how complex this looks. Just play with it. You're not going to break anything. Play with it. Have fun with it. It's a fun mod. So definitely recommend playing with it. All right. Take it easy, guys.